Mahala Loma Veatupu. I'll be presenting my bill on the legal review of sugar abuse. So, chronic health claims and endorsements have commonly been used by industry to promote and sell the drugs and the products. And here are some examples. So we have less than 2% fat, boostable vitamins A and D, 50% of your daily calcium needs, no added sugar, we have an endorsement there for blanket, and zero salt, protein and fiber, and part of the endorsement is the half star rating. And unfortunately at times these are misleading and have failed to take into account the sugar content of the products. And yeah, here we see that. So calcium actually has five teaspoons of sugar in it. The baby food has 4 teaspoons of sugar. Nutrigrain has 19 teaspoons of sugar. And this juice powder actually has 45 teaspoons of sugar. So there are a number of front of pack information labels that have been used, including this tick system. And it's the Health Foundation's guide for people to make healthy choices quickly and easily. So if a product has the symptoms, been approved by the Health Foundation with the traffic light system and also the health star rating system. Oh, sorry guys. Also the health star rating system that's been adopted here in New Zealand. So the heart tick, or the Health Foundation tick, was around for 25 years. The use of it was voluntary at first and then was mandated by the government after 13 years. So, and although this tick was retired in 2017, it provided new good insights into the usefulness of this type of label. And his example resulted in 33 tons of salt being removed from 3 food categories in 1 year. And prior to the tick, no independent nutrition info appeared from a pack. Unfortunately, inaccuracies around the impact that sugar has had on heart health led to it being retired. So the health star rating system also had similar issues regarding the value placed on sugar and the algorithm that determines how many stars the product receives. And so basically the higher the stars, the more healthy the product was. And here's an example of Milo, which is approximately 60% sugar. They got 4.5 half stars. Although the half star rating system has had changes, slight changes and improvements, the use of it is voluntary, so I haven't seen one on the package given. So today I'll briefly explain my study that we've been doing since 2018. The communities fight in sugar and soft drink study. And we worked for both 4 different high schools and conducted an intervention using a social marketing and gamification approach. And today I will present baseline results from our initial survey that, part of the discussion of interviews. And this info came from 1,766 CFI19 students. So there were a number of messages that we conveyed and through this, and one of it was our 369 message. And it's pretty much the maximum amount of sugar that a child, a woman, and a man can have per day. And so maximum sugar, or daily teaspoons of sugar for a child is 3, 6 for a woman, and 9 for a man. And we framed it as 369 because we thought it would be easier to communicate to the children. It was easier to remember, and resonated more with the children. And we used teaspoons as a measure because when we think about sugar intake, teaspoons. So in order for the kids to make sense of the 369 message, we need to teach them how many grams there were in 1 teaspoon. So So can anyone tell me how many grams there are in 1 teaspoon? Yes, so that'd be correct. So there's 4 grams in a teaspoon. So we taught the kids how to calculate the amount of teaspoons of brew in a common juice, like including fruit juices, fizzy, flavored milk. And this was a design, a graphic that we used to help convey some of these messages. And we displayed them around the tuck shops, around school grounds. So prior to our intervention, we asked the students how many grams there were in a teaspoon. And as you can see here, almost 80% or 4 out of 5 students got this question wrong. So generally, even if they had the nutrition label at the back of the product, they couldn't convert it into a meaningful unit such as teaspoons. So we also asked the kids about the daily recommendation of sugar for a child, a woman, and a man. And again, you can see here between 85 and 95% of the students answered this incorrectly. We also showed them these commonly sold drinks, and we asked them how many teaspoons of sugar were in these various drinks. And again, between 80 to 90% of the students answered these questions incorrectly. So from our study, it's clear that between 80 and 90% of the students had no idea of the recommended amount of sugar to be taken per day, or the maximum amount of sugar that they could have. They had no idea how to calculate sugar content into a meaningful unit. They had no idea of the sugar content in drinks, and therefore its relative proportion to a daily recommendation. So therefore, we think this makes a really strong case that in order for children to make better informed decisions, there needs to be clearer labeling of sugar content in drinks. So how do we propose we do this? We need front of pack labeling on sugar drinks, and the labels need to be clear. The labels need to clearly show how many teaspoons of sugar are in the entire drink and not per serving. And this needs to be mandated by government for all packaged drinks. And lastly, it needs to be supported by a social marketing campaign promoting the 369 message, but also explaining how many grams are in a teaspoon. So if we look at this example from before, it shows that the claim in the hack says no added sugar. But if you look at the nutrition label, it shows so there's 22.5 grams of sugar per serving. And there's 8 servings in this bottle, so 22.5 times 8 is 100 milligrams. And then you divide this by 4, so you get 45 grams of sugar in this bottle. So we know that there's 45 grams of sugar. And what we think is that instead of it saying no added sugar, it should show 45 teaspoons of sugar. And this is more clear, and it allows people to make better informed decisions on whether they want to buy the product or not. And here's a mock design that we came up with, and it shows how many teaspoons of sugar there is, and we think this would be useful. So this is policy 2 of the recommendations by the Mexican Beverage Guidance Panel. And again, to conclude and to reiterate, there needs to be compulsory labeling of sugar on drinks, and the labels need to be on all packaged drinks, and it needs to be mandated by government. The label needs to be front of pack, and the label needs to clearly show how many teaspoons of sugar there are in the entire drink and not per serving.